Opportunities in data science and AI are growing exponentially, and in this video I'm going to talk about the difference between two important roles in this field, which is data scientist and machine learning engineer. And we will evaluate it on three fronts, which is job duties, the skill set, and the salaries. So let's start with the job duties. The role of data scientist is to follow the complete data science process or a data science pipeline, which is understanding a business problem, collecting data, doing data exploratory data analysis, building a model, and drawing the insights. This is the duty of a data scientist. They follow all these steps and then they represent these insights to the stakeholders. So their job involves a lot of creativity, domain knowledge, understanding business problem, data cleaning techniques, and then of course machine learning, model building, and then generating insights. But often data scientists would build these models in dev environment, and when they have to deploy this to production, they take help of machine learning engineers. So now machine learning engineers are responsible for maintaining and creating the machine learning infrastructure so that they can deploy the models built by data scientists to production. And not only they can deploy, but to scale them. So when it comes to enterprise solution, you need to think about scaling the system using distributed computing so that you can serve the needs of clients in a time efficient manner. All of this activity is done by machine learning engineer. So you can see that data scientists are kind of the users of machine learning infrastructure that is built by machine learning engineers. And when I say deploying it to production, it could be deploying it to wearable device. You might have a wearable device which is tracking your heartbeats and using some machine learning model for doing some prediction. So how do you deploy that model on little wearable device which has less memory and computation resources so that it performs really fast? Think about autonomous cars. So Tesla cars can detect objects and it can do autonomous driving. So that car has little computer sensors and those are running those models. So how do you run those models in efficient way? How do you take care of errors? All of those things are the responsibilities of machine learning engineer. Think about technical skills. Data scientist and machine learning engineer role are quite overlapping. So many times if you go to small companies, machine learning engineers might be doing work of data scientists and vice versa. So there is a lot of overlap. But overall, there are few common skills, such as, of course, knowing about machine learning, predictive modeling, statistics and math, Python. These are common skills that both data scientist and machine learning engineer have. But on top of that, our data scientists are good in terms of telling the data stories, creativity, understanding business problems. So many times you will see data scientists will have a strong domain knowledge. For example, if you are in finance, a person might be a CFA, you know, he might have a strong finance background, and then that person will learn technical background and become a data scientist. Machine learning engineer, on the other hand, are core software engineers. They are very good in data structures, algorithms. They understand computer science. You know, it's kind of hard to become machine learning engineer without having a computer science background. They understand memory, CPU utilization, distributed computing, fault tolerance, log analysis. They know all of those cool computer science techniques. In terms of programming language, data scientists are good in either Python or R, whereas machine learning engineers will be good in C++, Java, Python, Scala, etc. Often machine learning engineers build their own algorithms. You know, when they write, let's say they are not happy with the default implementation of decision tree from sklearn, they might come up with their own implementation with little tweaks. And those implementations, they will generally do it in either Java or C++. They want the efficiency. They might use Julia as well. But you can see that they write low-level code, whereas data scientists work at a little upper level where they will use the modules or the libraries created by machine learning engineers in order to solve those problems. Data scientists often use BI tools such as Power BI, Tableau for doing data analysis. I have seen many times data scientists don't use ML at all. You know, they can do data science using Excel or Python pandas and Power BI. Whereas machine learning engineers, their core role is to do machine learning. So they will be doing machine learning, deep learning all the time. Whereas data scientists, machine learning is one of the tools for doing data science. Hence, data scientists might not be using, there might be a scenario where, you know, as a data scientist, you might not use machine learning techniques or deep learning for 6 months. For salaries, as per indeed.com, data scientists on average make $122,000 a year, whereas machine learning engineers make $148,000 a year. In India, data scientists make around 750,000 rupees per annum on average, whereas deep learning engineer, they are saying it's same, but don't go by this indeed.com numbers because they are average across different cities, different experience levels and so on. In reality, the salary range that you get actually varies too much. It varies based on your skill set, the city, the company that you are getting an offer from. And just to go over some of these examples, I'm going to go through this website called teamblind.com where people post their offers. You know, if the person has two offers from different companies and he wants to take other people's opinion, they will post these offers. And I looked at some of these. These are like real numbers. I have friends working for big FAANG companies, so I know that these numbers are real. So let's go over some of these numbers so you get a better idea. You can go to teamblind.com and search for any topic. Let's say I'm interested in machine learning engineer, and it will show me different posts related to machine engineers. And now these are not necessarily all job offers, but they could be general discussion about machine learning engineer. But it happens that many of these discussions are related to job offer. For example, here one person got a job offer from Twitter and Square as a machine learning engineer in both the companies, and he's comparing the offers. So in Twitter, he's offered $330,000 per year, whereas in Square, it is $390,000 per year. YOE means year of experience. Now this person has 9 years of experience. Machine learning career is fairly new, so all 9 years I don't think will be in machine learning field. It will be software engineering, and recently he might have become machine learning, and they get offer like this. Now this is not an exceptional offer. People get even more money than this, and the reason I want to show you all of this is because the salaries vary too much based on your experience, based on the company, the city, etc. Here is another offer from LinkedIn. The offer is around $200,000, but look at year of experience. The person is fresh graduate, only 1.5 year experience. You get $200,000 a year. Base is 145 and then 10% bonus, and RSU is restricted stock units. So $250,000 of stock unit over a period of 4 years. Now the tech stocks are booming. Stocks are going crazy high and people are earning so much money. Here is another offer for Square machine learning engineer, and the person is getting total $315,000 a year at Amazon, and with the Amazon stock growth in 2020, he'd be making $420,000 a year. Now this is level 6 at Amazon, of course few years of experience. So you see that machine learning engineer salaries could be, if you're in product-based company, could be more than $300,000. It could be $400,000. It could be even $500,000 a year. Yes, $500,000 a year. This is the reality. People are not posting lies here. And how do I know? Because I have contacts, I have friends who are working in these companies, and I know that these are all the facts, okay? No exaggeration. Now let's compare data scientist salary. So here someone is talking about Facebook data scientist, and the person has an offer with TC, means total compensation, $320,000 a year in Los Angeles. He has another offer from Uber, $390,000 a year, and the year of experience is 10 years. Uber data scientist in San Francisco, 3 years of experience, $140,000 plus $80,000 per year stock option. So around $200,000 a year for Uber data scientist. Another one for Facebook data scientist, 5 years of experience, 160 base and 15% bonus, $200,000 stock units over a period of 4 years. So let's say 50K per year. So this will be little more than $200,000. So you can see that machine learning engineers are getting paid much higher than data scientists. But if you're working for FANG companies, minimum you can expect $200,000. And based on experience, if you are PhD, for example, if you're done research paper, I have heard in Google you can get up to $700,000 a year. So go to this teamblind.com, explore different conversations, explore different offers that people are having. The reason I'm showing this to you is to show you the fact that the salaries vary too much based on the company to company, based on the region, based on your experience. It can vary anywhere from $100,000 to $800,000, okay? So the sky is the limit. If you are very good, skillful, you can earn hell lot of money. The world is full of opportunities. I hope that clarifies the difference between data scientist and machine learning engineer. Based on your skill set and interest level, you can choose to pursue one or the other career. And of course, if you're a data scientist, you can switch to ML, or ML person can switch to data scientist. So you always have that flexibility. You just saw that from the Team Blind review. People earn hell lot of money. I was talking to my wife and I was telling her that she works in a hospital. It's like machine learning engineers make more money than, you know, surgeons, doctor surgeons. So the career is very hot and in demand. So if you're interested in learning about data science, machine learning, I have many videos on my YouTube channel where I teach machine learning, Python, data science, data analyst skills, Tableau, Power BI for free. And all these tutorials are designed for complete, absolute beginners. You don't need any background. So I will go over all the basics in these tutorials. Then I do theory, then I write code, and also I have exercises, and I have interesting giveaways and challenges going on the website skillsbasics.com. So check out the content. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. I will see you in next video. Thank you.